an other way, the more casual way. I tell you that this one can be used in formal and informal situation, right? So in the informal situation, we have another way.
Older 지.
So I will tea. And you can see it as the personal pronoun. It is how we address each other. And the Vietnamese pronoun a little bit complicated. In comparison with other languages, for example, in English, we have only you and I, right?
Yeah.
It is unchanged. It is not changeable. But Vietnamese personal pronoun can be changed due to the age you see, right? And the gender, or even the relation. Very complicated. But today I just want to introduce you some.
Okay.
Actually, maybe we have nearly 20 ways to say. But I just want you to remember maybe 3 or 4 is enough. About the immersion, I have an example. I'm younger than you. But you shouldn't call me something like this. But go. Go use for the young lady. Go. So in the formal situation, for example at the hotel or the your business partner, you should say go is better. Do not say name. It is in formal situation. And it means miss. Because anyway, I'm a teacher, so you should call me Go.
Go
Yuki. So from now on, you can call me Go Yuki. And I'm going to call you Ba.
Ba. Ba. Ba. Ba.
No, it's Ba. At that time, I know that it can be difficult because you have a learned the pronunciation. Go Yuki. So next time, how can you say if you see me at the class next time? How can you say hi?
Go Yuki.
Ciao.
Ciao.
Go Yuki.
Ciao. Ciao.
Ciao. Go Yuki.
Ciao. Ciao.
Nice.
Go means miss.
Yes. Go miss. And now only the young lady.
Marco.
So it is my example. For example, it is you. Just